Shadow Demon, like we've seen, they like to have a roaming support. I wonder if they'll do something like that with Clockwork, maybe.
I think it's still open, but I think MNT like to play those type heroes that scale. We saw his Mirana scale intensely yesterday, so.
Cool.
I think we'd see the support Weaver for Red Venom. Yeah, it looks cool too. It scales, gives him more scaling potential as well, and gives him that type more Roche potential with the Drow Ranger and with the bugs.
But would it be played in the same way to get as big as Lil and his Weaver?
I think so. They usually prefer giving MNT a lot of farm, except for when Spartan's playing the Enigma, obviously.
I mean, all you've got to do is just be on the map with Drow. Yeah. Like, that's it. That's how you get this Weaver to be this dangerous thing. Right. You're just like, oh, there's Drow on the map. So.
And hope that nobody stays close to you.
Yeah.
That's it.
They get Drow Weaver.
So what's the S4 hero?
S4 hero. One more left.
We've seen crazy stuff from S4.
They banned Nature's Prophet, by the way, OG.
Yeah, they were expecting that clock to be support.
Yeah, I was not expecting Nature's Prophet, but obviously maybe they...
I mean, if you read Dota buff, Skylark has been not a lot of Nature's Prophet.
You think that's it?
I hope that's
not the case. Is that seriously what OG have done?
I hope that's not the case, but he used to play a lot of Nature's Prophet.
Teams do use that kind of stuff.
Oh, of course,
together,
yeah.
Look, because, I mean, what else can you really do?
Well, or perhaps they scrambled, like, who are we playing the Grand Finals against? Who are
OG's lacking time. Okay.
Legion Commander.
More illusion clear. It's able to remove the silences off of the OD as well if he does. And like we mentioned, they don't like to get BKB, so if he's able to do that, it's cool. And they can put a lot of pressure on the safe lane. And it's very good versus the Drow Ranger just to get on top of him. Yeah. You know, you always want to be able to cancel the precision aura for him. So Earth Spirit and Legion Commander are very good at being able to do that. And heavy team fight, and this gives them a little bit of a pick-off potential with that. So
okay.
Cool draft.
A good draft to start the Grand Finals,
yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right.
Both of them are very strong, so.
Let's do this. It is my great pleasure to start things off for the Grand Final of the Boston Major. The voices behind this Grand Final, there's an OD in-game and there's an OD at the desk, and he's joined by a magical presence. It's Malini.
Thank you very much, Alex. Indeed, we're here ready for the Grand Finals of the Boston Major. Best of five. At Finnum going up against OG. I'm hyped, Ben's hyped. As you can see behind me, the crowd as well is going pretty insane. What a matchup we've got on our hands, Ben. At Finnum, a team that just rose up incredibly quickly recently. 2 years ago, I remember casting Spartan and Madara at a UK LAN. They came over, they decimated UK Dota. Now they're here on the verge of decimating international Dota up against OG in this matchup. What's going to happen, Ben? Talk to me about At Finnum. What is it about them that's allowed them to get this far and be at this point where they could be OG two-time winners of the majors?
And look at Madara. Let's play some good dotes. And as you mentioned before, the Alp Malga probably making a lot of people happy. I think something special about Ad Venom is that they have a lot of unique drafts. This one is no different. This Drow Pug combination is actually something that OG use quite often. And of course, we see the support Weaver from maybe next time.
I'm gonna drop the ward down here, Ad Venom. Both sides getting a vision, but immediately dewarded by OG. OG themselves, not really with a good sort of initiation there from the high ground, so they're holding off. Thug. Thinking about scanning out again, has the orb up in a second, but both teams grouped up. Being very, very careful about who makes the jump. Oh, MNT kind of dropping down the Blightstone there, saying, come at me, bro. And it looks like nothing is going to come out of this for now. The Spartan can get a disruption, but both teams just respecting each other by the looks of it. And we'll head down to respective sides to pick up the bounty runes.
Yeah, Drow Aura is strong at level 1, but Lunar Blessing is even stronger, especially when they have that high ground positioning. And it looks like No-Tail may be positioning in the off lane up with Fly. So that'll be a little bit different. And it will be Skylark on the Clockwork and maybe next time on the Weaver. Support Clockwork might have not been the best this game just because there's no jungler for them to really deal with. It might be very hard for him to actually get kills and get experience. So having him as an offlane, much more reliable in terms of getting his level 6.
I mean, because of this lane pairing, the way that they have gone about it, OG, how is this laning stage going to go? Obviously, Ad Venom have that Drow Aura advantage. Does OG have the heroes to have the potential to come out on top in these early stages?
I think the Puck's actually a pretty decent matchup against the OD. Like, he can't really orb you down because you have phase shift. And, of course, with the Drow Aura, he does actually have more base damage than the OD in this early phase.
On top lane, Skylark taking a bit of a beating there from No-Tail and Fly, bringing him down to half health or so, and even more, in fact, with his Shadow Word, Skylark. And to be careful hanging back, so No-Tail certainly getting the space thanks to Fly for that CS to happen. Meanwhile, down bottom, Spartan, he's found S4 with the disruption. And as he comes across with the bugs, I'm going to be able to force S4 back underneath the tower. And make sure that this lane is as hard as they can make it for the Legion Command to take lane on his own.
That's a very hard lane to kill. I think they need to address the Luna at some point. The Luna and the Warlock do have pull open to them. This one's probably an unexpected lane fight between them, so they're not going to be able to ward out that pull. And now Fly's able to perhaps get level 2 and onwards very easily.
Yeah, Jarrett's trying to just make the side pull smart and trying to interrupt it. And at the moment, CS-wise, the mid lane 7-3 against the 7-1, very close between Thug and Ana, and both safe for cores, getting similar amounts now for 2. On the safe lane throughout, I have Venom mid lane, Ana keeping the harassment up onto Thug, but as expected, as you said, with that aura, and the fact that Puck can lane relatively well against the OD, seems to be going alright here for Thug.
And he has that high ground ward. It's definitely not to be underestimated. And Thug does have a salve, so he's a salve up on Ana. Ana should be able to get his bottle, I think, in this creep wave, which shouldn't be that big of a deal for him. He does orb out. Jerax is coming in from behind.
Yeah, this is going to be the Puck without his escape mechanism. Roll forward, but he's got the face shift to dodge the slow. He'll come in with a boulder smash, Thug. Is he going to be all right? Looks like he will. Nice little face shift there. Dodging the initiation of Jerax. And even without that orb, Thug remaining alive and had that salve ready to go. So back to full health. Jerax is going to continue to hang around though and try and get a bit more space for Ana to catch up and maybe try and get ahead in CS in this mid lane.
Yeah, this Luna is still free farming in that top lane though. I'd be very concerned if I were at Phenom, and Skylark is out of HP regeneration in that top lane. He's getting bullied out by Fly and No-Tail. He could potentially die over here.
Yeah, with this Shadow Word and Lucid Beat, Skylark, he's going to drop incredibly low. He's starting to come back in with a battery assault. Cog's down, but it doesn't matter. First flood there for OG. Fly will take the kill. No-Tail gets himself back to safety at the same time. Mid lane, Ana. For a bit of a setup onto Thug, Jarax. They come in, waits out the phase shift in the orb, but proving to be a little too hard for the Earth Spirit to have the control to bring down this Puck. Now, first blood for OG in that top lane, and as you said, certainly the lane where Abfinim are suffering the most. I mean, would you expect to see some sort of a rotation from some of the supports down bottom to go and help the clock?
Yeah, I think the Weaver can rotate up there. They only have one set ward on the Warlock. It wouldn't be that difficult for him to zone out. Maybe next time already moving about. The Shadow Demon had already blown his TP score on the mid lane, so it would have been quite the trek for him to go.
And Jarex moving rather far out on this mid lane. But it really is a question of whether MNT can... Not for that much. He's level 2. There's the bugs.
They need to use Astral, or they can make a move. And there's a DB on Ana, so he might be playing very aggressively. This might be the word to go.
And there's the Astral. MNT starting to shift forward a little bit. Now he's not going to move forward. But again, just ducks back out. A TP across from Fly just to make sure that no ganks will be incoming onto Ana. Get the D ward as well. So OG reclaiming good control of this mid lane after already establishing a very strong top lane for No-Tail.
So I think bottom lane is kind of a wash. Like LC is still getting good amounts of experience despite them not being able to get a kill on him. And top lane, they're already reinforcing. They know that Warlock had just TP'd mid and they're walking back up there because that's the lane that you want to deal with. A solo Luna in the off lane this early in the game without Eclipse is your prime kill target. But they're wrapping around behind on Thug. Earth Spirit with a 1-1-1 build, he has to be able to get the roll into the silence.
He's got to get the perfect timing here, Jarax. TP across will be there, goes for the silence first, into the stun, and though they try and take him down as five, he's there with the disruption third. He off, he face shifts, he's out. The right clicks will do it though. Ana finishes off Puck in the mid lane spot and trying to punish Ana's play, but Ana balls up, and he's even thinking about turning around it with the DD. He goes for spot, but five gets the final touch. Ana playing a little too aggressively for his own good there, throws away his life.
He maybe expected some support from Jerax in the river over there, but he wasn't able to bottle up to safety.
Well, whilst that was happening, will the action down mid Abfinim? Try and eye up No-Tail. No-Tail proving to be a little too tanky. He's got a few too many levels under the belt for the two of them to take out unless he's massively out of position. 2-1 at the moment, as you said, lane-wise, No-Tail's Luna having a great time, but still, the Drow down at the bottom, 32 CS at the moment.
Yeah, I guess by the same token, Drow Rangers are farming up there. And yeah, the Shadow Demon looked like a very easy kill, but it's something very easy to forget that he has Drow Aura. Your supports love that. It's like, yeah, great, I can farm creeps. I can actually right-click some cores.
Every right-click counts. Top lane, Jarax trying to make the initiation to Skylar. We'll drop down the cogs. Has the backup of MNT. Jarax and No-Tail aren't going to go in any deeper.
Spartan scouts out Fly in the river. And he knows that they're coming in. It's about to be 6 minutes. Can Spartan get the top down?
Coming in onto Jarax, but he immediately silences Skylark in return. Matter of moving down. He's going to gust up Jarax. Jarax, he's good enough. And No-Tail, he could be in trouble as well. MNT a little low on the mana though, so can't dive forward. Matt sees if Could get a reach in. Muto will survive Salva. Meanwhile, back towards the mid lane. Thug takes down Ana with the help of Spartan. And some sweet plays there from Abfin and bringing them ahead in the lead in terms of kills now. 3-2. And already proving to be a very, very close early game here between these two sides. 6.5 minutes in.
I wonder how the Legion Commander is going to itemize. Like, Blink is... It's sometimes difficult to buff just because of the cast point of Duel, like versus a very easy to escape hero like the Puck. Sometimes Shadowblade is a...
Top lane Matter are kind of caught out here. Intel not messing around, goes straight in with the Eclipse and takes him out. A little too far away from any sort of creep wave or backup. That ult will do the job. No Tail is sitting at the top of the net worth at the moment, as we can see, but it's very close between the four cores. Not much in it at all.
It's been a big game of chicken in the top lane. They don't want to leave their like exposed core. I would say like Luna and Drought are still very weak at this point in the game, and they constantly have rotate supports in and supports out. And if there isn't a support there, the other team will just sweep in and get that huge kill.
Again, in the mid lane, Astral has been used, and that is going to be a bit of the opening for Thug to try and make a go. Goes to the orb, jukes out the smash there with a phase shift, jumps across to Ana. He's got two stacks of poison, the silence as well, bringing the OD low. Ana, he should pop it, and he will. They'll get the kill on the OD. They'll now look towards Jarrett, and they've got the setup as well. Spartan with the disruption, they'll take down the second Abfinim. With a beautiful duo of plays there.
This early game from the OD has just been a disaster after giving up that one kill to the Shadow Demon. Shadow Demon was level 5 at that point with level 3 Soulcatcher. 40% more damage on a generally tanky hero like an OD. Those raindrops aren't going to save you.
Make big things happen. With those plays on the verge of hitting 6, Demonic Purge is thrown into the mix next time around those ganks come through. We'll see that replay again, and just really nice position. And again, it's just Abfinim seeing that opening anytime Ana uses the Astral aggressively.
Yeah, he's like, why am I taking so much damage? He waited out the Dream Coil, didn't want to get stunned by it, and Jirax wasn't able to connect on his boulder, and it will be an easy 2-0 for them.
And the disruption not only just setting up, but also making sure that Fly couldn't get the Shadow Word heal onto Jirax. And the Spartan. A relatively calm Spartan as well, but understandably so, it's early days.
He looks very intense, though.
Intense, but he's not smashing anything up yet. But still, I mean, at this stage of the game, I guess there's certainly both teams have positives to take away from this early beginnings, but Abfinim certainly making the plays happen, and they're not stopping yet.
Oh, mid lane Skylark
with the hood immediately coming in onto Fly, and indeed 7 experience away from the 6 there. So no chance for Fly for anything in sorts of a turnaround, and in fact, S4 comes forward. Million Dollar Dream Core kind of hitting him back. He's been caught out. The Eclipse comes through, but the destruction was Spartan. It may just say, no, there's Jarrax with time and gets the smash and the silence out. So despite Spartan's best efforts, they'll not be saved.
Maybe next time hovering around, maybe trying to get a kill on S4, but he will take the long way around to the left side as they avoid the Weaver. Very nice defensive disruption. 2 ultimates for that. The Puck thought he could get the silence off, but it is only level 1 silence, and the duel came out just in time. Have to respect the LC. If LC gets a duel on Puck, it's going to be a tough team fight for Abfinim, because that's most of their AoE control in the fight.
Yeah, Abfinim have to be a little bit careful up on the stop lane now. Fly, he's come up here, he's got the backup for both Ana and S4 in the neighborhood.
They want to use the rock.
He does have the rock, yeah. Abfinim will surely be aware that they'll see that Fly is level 6. S4 starting to come across, but it's all warded out. Collision in this area, Spartan immediately just holding him back. Mass TP is now coming through from Abfinim. They want to try and fight this Demonic Purge. So straight down onto S4. He tries to purge it off, but that ain't going to happen, son. With the rest of the attack, he's out. Fly now in a bit of a situation. Ana will try and save him for the time being with the Astral, but he's surrounded by Abfinim. They'll take down the Warlock. Ana's trying to TP out. He was short. In fact, he stops. He looks towards Thug. He's trying to turn it around with the help of Motel and Jarrett. Thug falling low. Silence Thug. Jarrett should be able to find the hook, and he will. But at the same time, it's 2-1 at the moment. Ana's falling incredibly low, heads down towards the south on the retreat. OG starting to turn this one around potentially. MNT's still about. No Tail and Jarrax. A little too high for them to finish off. Lucid being down onto Spartan, but no more further chase down there from OG. They may have lost 2, but they do manage to take down Thug in return.
And they would have loved to have that Eclipse there for that fight. The Puck was huddling towards the top side of the cliff, hoping for a defensive disruption from the Shadow Demon while he was silenced, but they were unable to get that off. And OG did not commit Rock to the fight, so they can perhaps take another fight on that top side of the map, but these skirmishes are not going their way. And OD is very far behind in net worth. It's okay if the Puck's kind of held around that 3,000 area, because he's not really meaning to scale. As long as the Drow gets farmed, he gets right-click damage in the meantime. And he's going to have his Veil
Radiant soon. Tower is under attack. Absolutely, the Veil. Going to benefit multiple heroes on his side. One's going to be very happy when that comes online as well. Extra damage out from the Shadow Demon. The comparison at the moment. The kill participation, better for Thug. And indeed, the hero damage nearly double coming out from this Puck. And it's obviously going to go even higher with that Veil being picked up around the corner. OG, trying for a smoke. They really want to make something happen here with the Chaotic Offering and the Eclipse back online. Espo's got the duel. If they find a target, they'll almost certainly find a kill.
Puck's not the target that they can go on. Legion Commander, no Blink Dagger. There's no way to stop him from just orbing, phasing.
He's got the Invis rune now.
Oh, that's a big one. That's actually, I think, the best rune for the LC right now.
So we can see, though, Ad Finnem sort of fortunate here in their movements. They're actually looking down towards the bottom. They know that Anna's alone. Anna's going to try for the TP out, but there's the vision. And Scarlet just casually walks in, has the battery assault. And I don't think there's any escape here for this OG. There's no TPs coming through. OG just letting Anna die here in this situation. There's no way they can save him.
Is that worth losing T1 tower in their mid, though, OG?
They might not even lose it. Ad4 already over, maybe looking for the defense. They have the Dream Core. They have all ultimates available. Scarlet with that play as well down bottom, and he was very cool about it. Didn't blow out a hookshot. He still got that ready for this mid lane fight. Can he find the lead in?
Oh, he was so close to getting coiled under the tower. That would have been disastrous. Fly in a very good position to drop a rock. He's just a little bit to the north, hiding behind No-Tail.
Oh, they've got to be careful how much they group up. Targeting low, and Thug gets the deny. And the back lane lines the middle, though. MNT has kind of taken the attention away from OG as they were drawn towards him. But Ad Finnem, you know, not only just getting that OD kill down on the bottom, also getting the curry, denying tier 1, getting a nice little bit of a momentum here. OG potentially being slightly thrown off their game in these early stages.
Yeah, if they get it up maybe next time, they have to be especially careful of Roshan, potentially coming out very soon. Weaver has a double minus armor build, Medallion of Courage, and Blightstone. He's been a little bit quiet this game, but that will allow them to set up on Roshan. You don't want to take the fight when Rock and Eclipse are up, at least not if they're not pushing the top tower, but is kind of, I think, what they're eyeing next. I don't even know who you put on, Drow, Ranger, or Puck, but either of them are both pretty good at this point. Offensive smoke coming out from Advent.
See if they can catch out. OG have started to split back up a little bit around the map. I mean, they've obviously tried for two attempts with these big ultimates to make something happen, and they just haven't found the window. Leaving No-Tail farming on his own down bottom.
Doesn't want to shoot a rocket. If he shoots a rocket, he reveals his positioning, but at the same time, he does want to hook
Scarlet
this Luna.
Might find him anyway. No-Tail, just outside of the night vision at the moment. Scarlet won't spot him out. And with that rocket, they will already S4 Ann. And Jarek's being coiled up. But again, Ad Finnem holding back, not wanting to initiate a round here. So close to the tier 1, they know that there's going to be backup, and they know that OG still have these huge team fight ultimates at their disposal.
Yeah, that would have been like a 3-man Fatal Bonds had they ran up there. And maybe Nightmare feels very safe with that Sentry Ward in the mid lane, but still trying to draw out the rock as long as possible. Still 15 minutes in, have not seen one use of it.
This has to be frustrating for OG. I mean, as we see that the team fights aren't working out, is it just a case of waiting for certain items? You know, S4 working towards that potential Blink Dagger? Is there something that could allow them to change the fortune here in trying to make fights happen rather than just running down a lane?
The Blink Dagger on S4 is probably the biggest one, but on top of that, OD just needs any sort of item on him. Like, he is just dirt poor. He was neck and neck with the Puck, but now Puck's pulled ahead by a good 1,000 gold. Like, OD needs items. Force Staff, Veil, anything, really. Midas, perhaps.
In fact, Ad Finnem, looking towards Roshan, they've got very good warding around the Radiant Jungle entrance to it all. So Ad Finnem are going to feel confident going in for the kill here. It's already falling down to half with the Drow and the Medallion from MNT. They're taking it down at an incredible pace. And it doesn't look like there's going to be any chance that OG can stop it. They'll send a creep across, but it's already too late. Roche is down, and Madara has the Aegis in his hands.
I really like the build from MNT for that, though. The double minus armor from the Medallion Blight and adding value from the Swarm. It just makes Roshan that much easier. And I think they chose to do it as soon as the Drawrinker hit level 11, knowing that with that amount of agility, the timing that OG have to hit, especially that T1 tower, is just minimal.
OG desperately trying to make some sort of action happen here, going their way. Jarrett smokes up, eyes onto Thug up top. Again, it's such a hard kill to get if he doesn't hit that combo, and he needs the follow-up damage. Anna does have a DD under his hands at the moment.
Ooh, they smoked. Don't think it was in Observer Ward range. They're hiding behind those two trees.
Oh, and S4 is, of course, in the jungle, just trying to finish off.
Yeah, he's at 2,000 gold.
That blink, it'd be very painful if there's his life at this stage of the game, but it looks like Skylark and Spartan have their sights set towards the mid lane. Motel there at the moment towards the Ancients is going to start farming some of those up. Again, just not quite finding the vision here, Finning. So they'll continue to move up towards the top lane where Anna has found space and time to take down a tier 1.
They're expecting a smoke from OG, is what they're doing. And that wasn't actually a massive smoke. They're patrolling around the high ground, waiting for it to pop. But now, LC does have his blink dagger. Same time, Puck has his. And Shadow Demon's positioning going to be crucial for the next fight. Earth Spirit, if he can get a silence on the Shadow Demon during the duel, that's also going to be pretty big. And of course, the Rock Drop and the Fatal Bonds, look for that.
And Matter has just picked up a Shadow Blade as well. So add Finnum with a multitude of ways to jump into the fights. And they are certainly looking for one now. As they move over to OG's half of the map, looking to take the tier 2 from down on the bottom lane. At the same time, though, OG attempting their best to push out multiple lanes. You've got Anna pressuring up top. Bit of a movement from OG, sweeping the jungle of Afinim, seeing if they find any stragglers, but the full force of Afinim is indeed all down here. So they take a tower themselves, Afinim, and OG may be able to find a trade, but at the same time, Afinim, they look to potentially move on, and they could be on verge of forcing OG to back up and fight them. It looks like they actually want to fight them up top. A mass TP's up towards the top lane, but OG have all but backed up, so you aren't going to see the teams butt head as of yet, as both simply avoid each other. But Afinim take the tower, and OG can't quite finish off the trade.
No tail, perhaps just dragging a little bit high and trying to clean out that dire jungle. He does have HOD creep, very useful in just adding his team damage, as well as potentially blocking a hookshot. I think that's probably one of the biggest plays that you can make with the HOD creep in this game. And pushing high ground into Fatal Bonds, you don't want to be in a position where multiple people are going to get destroyed by the Fatal Bond. They can easily pick up the OD with the Shadow Blade right now, and Spartan, he's been a lot more involved. Rock has just constantly been avoided by Adfinum. When's he gonna drop it away?
That is the question. Coming up 19 minutes in and still Flop struggling to find the situation to offer his column to the fight.
They don't have any smokes left on OG. The next one pulls down in 1 minute and 40 seconds, but I don't know if they can wait that long before they choose to fight. And us Rocket player scouts out two of them. They know where Fly is. I think they might have seen him place a ward too.
Radiant's coming through though now into the mid lane. Anna moving across and has got the sentry ward down. Will pick up MNC and start to hammer into him. And in fact, jumping in with the duel, S4 will catch the bug out. That sentry ward certainly paying off there. They get the kill and they also get that tasty bonus damage for S4. Well, up top, fight's not over yet. It's Jarrett hunting for Spartan. The pings will come out. They know he's there, but Spartan's already headed off to the side. Gets silenced up. Notel and Jarrett surrounding him. Spartan, no way he lives out of this one. He will be taken down. So OG not only finding that kill in the mid lane, get a good kill up top, and that may allow the momentum to finish off this tier 2 on the top lane.
And not having to expend any big ultimates, that's exactly what OG needs to keep this momentum, keep on pushing with the Luna, keep building up net worth on the Outworld Devour. Puck hasn't really been able to get any pickups with his Blink Dagger yet. And nighttime has come, definitely giving OG the edge in this next team fight, unless Puck can get a multiple man waning rift.
It's going to be all about Thug's initiations indeed in this team fights, making sure OG don't have the chance to cast those ultimates. Anna is starting to work towards finishing that Hurricane Pike. MNT, level 9 at this stage, and Anna himself, and he has that Dragon Lance out and complete. 20 minutes in. That's been a bit of a troubling start for OG in terms of trying to make the fights happen, but as we've seen with that last bit of play, they're certainly able to find the pickoffs and have Finn McCord out of position.
I don't know if they're going to be able to make the use of the Aegis. It just expires, so The net worth actually has swung the way of OGs in the past few minutes. It's almost at par. That one pickoff on maybe next time actually gave them a lot. As Evan, we're not five strong to go up into the next team fight. So, Luna...
What is the build here? Is he going for
I
the
think
axe?
He's going for axe.
He's going for the agony. I mean, talk to me about this, Ben.
I guess it could also be a Scotty Rush, but the axe of Luna is actually very, very strong if they don't have BKBs, and I don't really think any of these heroes are going to build BKBs anytime soon. The thing does so much damage. It's risky because your physical damage might not scale as well.
I mean, I guess what you've got Anna on the OD to set up for the late game, yeah. Right click, and you've also got S4.
Yeah, they can just like dump it on door. That's almost a guaranteed dual win as long as Shadow Demon doesn't get his ultimate off. It could also be just be a casual one if he feels like he needs more HP and just needs to survive. But it's a very unusual.
I saw it on the bottom lane here. Anna simply gonna Astral Thug him back away. MNT was in the neighborhood as well, but the two members of OG decided to not take that fight.
S4 walks into Observer Ward range.
They know he's here. Madara closing the gap with the Shadow Blade, but immediately S4 blinks back. Madara jumps forward here with the Hurricane Pipe, trying to finish him off, but with the Blade Mail and the Shadow Word, is it going to be enough to save him? The Rock? It will! They keep S4 alive! The question is if OG can find anything in return. They'll land the Lucid Beam onto Madara. Madara will deliver the Dream Call for Thug, holds back OG, and Madara will be allowed to escape there.
Wow, one hit away, and the Clockwork will get dueled up at the end of the day. He did shoot that rocket uphill just so he could get, hopefully, what would have been that last hit on the Legion Commander, but the Shadow Word coming out just in time from the Warlock. That would have been devastating had the Draw Ranger died at this point. But now you can tell that Ochi's team fights are much more comfortable grouping up now.
And they found a bit of a crack, a bit of an opening, and they're ready to abuse it. Walking down the mid lane with the clone still up and healthy. Mid lane as well. Planning eyes on Tamad, but duel still on 40 seconds. But indeed, so far this game won everything we've hoped it to be 9-9, 23 minutes in, can still go both ways. And that's back into his jungle, and in fact, yeah, will spot out the. Actually, a bit of a roll forward, be hoping to find the connection, but MNT juking and out at the moment, just taking bomb here from OG's jungle. And there it is, 23 minutes in, no tail with this Aghanim set. Luna build in the Grand Finals.
I'm a big fan of the Aghs.
You love yeah, good timing as well.
Yeah, it's really strong. It complements exactly what they need. They don't really need her to do that damage physically. I think just being able to drop that Eclipse onto the LC or just in an area is going to be really, really devastating. Like, I don't think they're going to see this too. It's very difficult to itemize against. Pipe against that amount of magic damage. It's not something that you can switch to like right in 24 minutes into the game. You have to prepare for it. And it also will like alter the way that OG farm a little bit too, because he's not going to be as strong at taking ancients.
I'll see if they find the opportunity to use it here in this mid lane push.
Yeah, I think you just drop it on S4 as the rock comes out, and by the time you like phase shift or Shadow Blade, the damage is going to be done.
Trying to make an initiation here, and then we have it, but the Eclipse drop down on the area of the ground, and it pummels through them! You get a beam, and everyone gets a beam! No tail! Knocking down both of them!
They're probably like, what the hell just happened? Right there.
He could be in trouble as well. Will be stunned up. A sentry's dropped as well. Garrett has eyes on him, and he's back up, and he's going to get in the form of Anna and fly immediately with the time-lapse. But Anna, he gets the Astral setting him in place. Silence is there as well, and they'll find themselves a third. OG, incredible ingenuity there.
That perfect positioning by the Eclipse there, right on air. And Drow Ranger didn't really know what to do. She thought she was like looking for the Luna. Like, where?
I mean, there's no escape. You don't see the air. It's as we saw. You just melt. And BKBs, as you mentioned, pause on Anthem. They're not going to want to build them anytime soon. I mean, potentially do you feel that Madara is going to be in a situation where he has to think about fitting it into his Drow build, or does he still have to avoid it?
I think you just have to split push at this point. So yeah, he drops this like right on top of where the puck is, and then she gets stunned out by the boulder and just dies in one stun. And then Martin's trying to fog it up too, but he also just gets blown up. So like the Luna beams appearing twice as fast is no joke. It's very difficult to react to, and of course it'll stop your blink daggers. And the one who kind of can save himself is the puck.
Yeah,
that's
Thug was very close to dying there.
Yeah, I think you just have to split push at this point, though. Their team fight is unrivaled. Even when you get BKBs, it's still risky because they can duel you before you pop your BKB. They can drop the rock and then combo that with Earth Spirit Stun. And by that time, you might already be dead from the Eclipse. So taking that risk in team fights is probably not something that they want to push at this point in the game. Just keep taking down Roshan's, keep avoiding the big Fatal Bonds rock combo, and try and get pickoffs with your Jarmander, who has the Shadow Blade.
OG ready to move around as a five-man again. We'll smoke up. No wards from Abfinim catching out. We'll see if Abfinim are prepared.
Spartan's in a perfect place to pop it, and he has the Observer Ward. So,
yeah, this is really smart position. Immediately just TP's out as soon as he senses danger. Skylark as well, walking himself away. Anna tried to jump forward. Will get the Astral. They will manage to get the lock on this. S4 closes the gap. Oh, no! Skylark hookshots away, and the drive-by stun holding S4 back, meaning no jewel to hold him in place. Very, very smoothly done there by Skylark, and just overall, as you said, Spartan's positioning, meaning that gank was not going to find a kill. Bottom lane, Jarrett's trying to fight up against MNT. Will hold back the Weaver with a stun. Anna is to back him up with the sentry drop. They should find this kill. MNT trying to keep himself at the time. That's trying to get out of range of the sentry as well. He will manage to keep himself safe. Jarrett goes for the swing. Oh, and he shoots and he scores. Jarrett finds him in the tree line. So they will punish the Weaver, despite MNT's best efforts to get outside of the range of that sentry.
Ah, that original Earth Spirit flare. Showing off his skills right there. And I think OG are actually probably strong enough to walk inside the Roche Pit and not really fear too much from Abfinim. If you're fighting from over there, you're not going to have any creeps.
And look at this, Ben. We are going to see the tree here of S4. So, come on.
He gets greedy with the press attack, too. Yeah. He presses the attack a little bit, like, right as
he goes for both. He tries to land the Q as well before the duel.
He didn't think there was any way that he was going to escape. But
he didn't expect the shine. Okay, no tell. He didn't expect it either. He's trying to turn around and cast the ultimate of sorts. There will be a KOD offering, buying in time to get out of there. Now no tell turns. One loosened beam to the head, and they find the kill. Fly there with the support to allow no tell to escape and turn that venture around. And they're not about done yet, OG. Rex moving forward, Spartan behind the tower. He'll actually disrupt himself, but S4 and Jarrett, they're wrapping around. S4 really wants to find some sort of a jewel. This time he'll get it. The two of them catching out Spartan. A nice plus 42 damage now in S4's bank. OG, again, they're just going from kill to kill ballers where they jump forward. They found the lockdown on Madara. They drop down the Eclipse Aghanim's ultimate from No Tail. And there really is no escape from that spell, Ben.
Yeah, this... I think Abfinim fans are probably worried about like OG slowing the game down, because that's where Abfinim kind of tend to make a little bit more mistakes. It's not the sort of game that they're used to. They want more like hectic, just constant brawls, constant skirmishes, constant pushes, and defense. But right now, it's OG just moving around together, and Abfinim are like kind of moving in there one at a time, trying to pick up a hero or two.
Abfinim are a hero down. They know there's no chaotic offering. They know there's no eclipse. They may go for a bit of a play here. Roshan falling low. Look, has the Dream Coil. The hookshot as well. Lots of forms of initiating. And OG playing fairly timid, in fact. They don't want to finish it off. They know that Abfinim have the favorable fight around here with the status of the ultimates in mind.
It's so low. It's at like 25%. I mean, they can't leave it.
They really can't. As soon as that drow's back online, Madara and the boys will head immediately over to the pit. MNT is going to find No Tail. No vision, of course, on these two cores at the moment, so MNT will be fine just scouting out the side of OG, giving the information that Abfinim need. And they'll know that OG, they're out and away from the pit. Deso now picked up by MNT as well, so Abfinim can make incredibly short work of this. Madara Hurricane Pikes in the pit. Hooked up towards where Jarex is there. He's trying to look for Madara. He kind of jukes him out there on the vision edge of the pit. They've got the ward down. He shadow plays Madara and gets himself away. The Samus is a glimpse, not enough to finish him off. S4 does find the Blink Jewel onto the SD. Jarex finishes off Madara. So OG gets the two kills that are crucial. They'll go back in. Abfinim still want to try and do anything about this. They do have Dream Coil. Hookshot, of course, off on cooldown. Doug, will he make an attempt for big old play? He's going to jump. He goes for the silence, but immediately Jarrett is there with the reactions. The silence
for the beatdown. OG, take the kill, take the Aegis. And Jarax, he was ready for that puck play.
Yeah, and they were ready for even that four-step in by the Drow Ranger. They had an Observer Ward on the high ground that I don't think Ad Phantom expected them to have. And that was a very high-risk place, four-stepping into there. So, like, maybe if they were smoked, it would have been much safer. But OG knew he was inside the pit. They had cover ground with sentries. And just once you take down a Drow Ranger, most of their damage is gone.
And we're really starting to see OG come into their own now. No tail. Leading by a fair margin on the overall net worth in comparison to Madara. And of course, at the start, as we talked about, Anna did struggle a little bit in the early game, but he's pretty much picked up all that he fell behind, and now very much leading in comparison to the Farm on Thug's Pup. As the recent fights have just favored OG each and every time, the shot calling just seems to be a little bit better here in this game one, as they lead 19-9, 31 minutes in, and have a favorable advantage in terms of money.
They're getting much more use out of their gold too. Like Luna doesn't have to go for a BKB, neither does the OD, and they can both get covered by the Legion Commander. Legion Commander can stop the silence from the puck, they can just turn around and man up with the press of the attack, and at Phantom, they're forced to go defensively versus this massive Eclipse Bomb. No Tail's level 18 right now.
Nice four. Being very close to being found out there by Ad Phantom.
They need to be able to pick off the Luna, or at least get a disruption on her. I think that's also one huge benefit of the Axe build this game. If you disrupt a Luna, it's not like she has Mantis style, she doesn't have Butterfly. She's not going to be destroying your own team with the Glaives.
It's all about the ultimate for No-Tail, as we've seen, but soon that situation will change with the amount of bank that he has. We'll be able to transition into that more standard kind of build on the Luna. If he wishes to do so. OG coming across towards the mid, they'll force Ad Phantom away, and Ad Phantom indeed respecting the fact that Chaotic Offering, Eclipse is back online, and these are two ultimates that they do not want to tackle head on, especially with No-Tail having that Aegis in his hands.
Yeah, I wonder what No-Tail's going to go for next, actually. If they want to push high ground, yeah, they do need more right-click from him, but he's kind of been itemizing against the Shadow Demon Disruption, so he might continue to do so. Like, I don't think Lincoln's is the worst choice in the world here. It will continuously prevent the disruption, and they don't actually have that many single target spells to pop it. Or you can just go into and or Butterfly, which is the most common. No-Tail. Looking up, maybe next time. Maybe next time hasn't been able to have too much of an impact, just because the supports haven't been alone. They've always been with someone, and the Earth Spirit like tries to buy enough time for his teammates if he goes onto him. The Warlocks just drops a rock, and you can't get solo picks as the Weaver this game. And the one time he did try to split push, he got Astral into a duel, which without a Lincoln's, you're going to be dead again.
OG now with their power, they're not looking for split push, they're looking for full on 5-man push on this side. Thug to cut the creep wave, and at the same time does have Matter and Spartan forcing down the top. They'll need to do something about this potentially very soon. OG making this push happen with Aegis in No-Tail's hands, take down the tier 2, and it looks like they may move on for more and try and force Ad Phantom back.
So Puckett's gone for a Lincoln's, probably doesn't want to get dueled. And base racing versus Luna, usually a terrible idea, but because she doesn't have that much right-click damage, it might not be the worst thing for them. They just have to be able to BKB and TP out, which isn't a possibility versus the Warlock or the Legion Commander. And now OD has shown up in the lane. Two heroes are hiding in the trees, Madara, and he's looking for them. S4 blinks aggressively.
In fact, he might spot before the TP successfully. Indeed, he's going to find him, but oh, he can't quite cast it out again. He goes for the W before the straight-up duel, submitting the opportunity to hold back the Shadow Demon.
And Ad Phantom looks like they're grouping up for a smoke. The call has been made, especially with the DD on Thug. They are grouped up close to their secret shop. I think it's maybe a good time for them just because a couple of the members TP'd all the way to the left side of the map, but they have to group up around Spartan, maybe wanting to set up some Observer Wards to make sure that they aren't caught out yet. But now it's too late. OG have already regrouped S5. As they huddle down the mid, and Luna has gotten a refresher.
Axe refresher is the build for No-Tail this game. He is going all in on it.
Yeah, that's really nasty, and SD does not counter the zero at all with this build.
Madara, he finds Jarax, but immediately with the ghost, they're actually going to drop the Dream Coil down here. I says,
time to bounce.
you're not finding anything there. Sad Phantom indeed will just reset back up.
He just has now fallen out.
They need to push out the lanes and or use a precision aura to prevent this push. Like, Luna is incredibly strong. I'm pretty sure she could probably team wipe all five of them. And imagine that with Fatal Bonds, that's going to be disgusting.
Oh my goodness, and here we go, Anna. He's just picked up the Hex and using it there to help out S4. Yet another successful dual win. 20-9, it's looking incredibly approachy, and as you said, I mean, they could go high ground, just drop down two ults around the racks, and there's not a lot that Adfinim can do to try and fight underneath it in terms of defending their buildings.
Thug might get hexed up here. They do need to use the four staff to pop the Lincolns.
They're rolling forward, Jarrison for the initial control. He's got the sound, he's got the stun, dropping everything down. They'll shove him back. Here come the Balls of Fury from Anna.
Too many pickoffs on the side lane. Adfinim trying to stall this game out, but they're just giving up way too many kills in the process. No tail out alone. This could be a big eclipse from them. If they try and engage, they're trying to wrap around from behind.
This is a risky fight for Adfinim to take S4. Pops the BKB, looks towards Spawn, immediately locking down the Shadow Demon, winning another duel. Now he'll turn towards Madara, chasing down the Drow Ranger, who's trying to turn, trying to fight. He will go to the BKB TP out and will indeed get himself away successfully. But again, Adfinim to lose two. And unable to fight into the power that is OG at this stage of the game.
Yeah, OG have the perfect mix of team fight and anti-split push to keep this train rolling. And No-Tail, I think this is his peak with Ags and Refresher Orb. They might as well use it while it's going to be at its strongest. Skylark doing his best to stop it with the Power Cogs and maybe next time in the middle lane with a Creep Skip on the Weaver, but this train is coming.
Here's the push in. Adfinim 5 seconds and they will have everyone back up. Quick fortification will force them away, and as you can see, MNT did skip the creep wave in that middle lane. Making it just that bit harder for OG to find the opening to go up to the high ground, and indeed, as we can see across the map, that's something that Adfinim have been able to do, just make sure that no creep wave is close enough to bring down that backdoor protection.
Problem is OG is not under any timer. They still have a lot of room to grow on the OD who was initially poor, and Luna still has, you know, one, maybe two more item slots where she can just get bigger and bigger. And Legion Commander has been able to get a fair amount of pickoffs on the supports, but comparing No-Tail and Madara.
And just the hero damage, as expected, just being doubled here by No-Tail. With this item build, it's something that Adfinim will have surely have not expected coming into this matchup.
S4. Invis up, will he be able to get the jump on Madara?
He's sort of alone at the moment. Spartan and MNT around towards the south of him. They will scan him out, so they know that he's there. Does also have Jerax close by, and in fact, Jerax running forward. Spartan maybe looks to try and do something here. In fact, he's just got to disrupt himself and hope for the best as S4 winning again. I mean, 110 stolen damage at 38 minutes. Very impressive indeed here from this Legion Commander.
Yep, and that has to be the call to push out the other lanes as quickly as possible. Those two heroes are the two best ones to pick out the side lane pushers, but you have to stop this five-man fight from happening.
That's looking very, very scary for Adfinim. OG rising up to this Grand Finals and already in Game 1 showing us just the power that this team has behind them. An incredible opening performance. I mean, No-Tail, as we can see, just 507, 330 CS, 20,000 net worth. It's been an impeccable performance from him, and he has that confidence. He can just go up to this tier three, feeling very, very safe, getting the damage out, and knowing that at this point it's so hard for Adfinim to do anything about it.
And they will choose to defend. They do have the HOD creep inside of Roshan, but it is almost a maximum respawn. Madara looking for a gank, but with these Hurricane Pikes on the Radiant side is very, very hard.
Yeah, he's surrounded and yeah, no messing. TP's away. Can't be caught out in this area of the map at this stage of the game. They need that man alive. Jarrett, the gem now as well, so more map control will be going the way of OG. What is the best bet for Adfinim now at this stage? Is it a case of waiting for OG to come for this sort of a push, or is it all about the split now for them so that they just have to avoid OG's team fight?
You have to avoid a team fight. I think the only hope of them winning a team fight is that they burst down the Luna, but they have Defense Astral, they have Press the Attack, and they have the Rocks to cover her tracks. That is way too many abilities to even hope that you can burst her down before the fight starts. Alternatively, you could burst down OD, but I don't think that's really a likely possibility either. Like, where is their burst coming from? There's no Dagon on the puck this game, which he's gone for in the past few.
And here comes the put. OG ready to go in full force. They'll get the silence. The Hex now dropped down onto a second. They'll find not just a Spartan, a Skylark as well. That's two out for Abfinim. And OG will be able to make short work here of this mid set of racks. Though, strumming down the Veil, nothing more as of yet. No-Tail still has that double ultimate at his disposal. He doesn't even need to use it at this stage. It's just the threat of it that holds Abfinim back and allows OG to get those racks absolutely smashed in the mid lane.
The way that Abfinim have gotten this far is by keeping it a relatively stable sort of game for them, and I think No-Tail was really the player in this game that changed the state of play with his scepter. It just destroyed that first fight and was just a do not pass sign in any of these team fights.
They know that he's hiding here. They have that ward down. They know he came down the lane. They're hunting from a Jax. He'll find him. Eclipse drop down into the tree line. No-Tail and Jax making it happen. Shiva's car picked up by Anna as well.
S4, is he going to get a pickup over here?
Apparently thinking about it, but two of them nearby, knowing that there's potential backup from Spartan on the disrupt. He doesn't go for it. Now he's looking as he moves in. Jack pressing silence onto the puck. I thought, puts himself away here with the face, there'll be a buyback from Madara. As he realizes that his team desperately need him at this stage. Now he looks to be trapped, but he should be able to get him. And indeed he does with the blink. But this is getting very close to being the final defense potentially from Abfinim. As OG have just played this game absolutely perfectly. They had a bit of a rocky start at the beginning, but ever since No-Tail's itemization, the Jarrett's Earth Spirit play, the fact that S4 was able to find just pick-off after pick-off. Ooh, M&T? We'll snap down the courier. That was, I believe, the Manta Star recipe from Luna. Oh, No-Tail isn't going to have that, but I don't think that's going to be the biggest of his worries. It's OG with the space to move into the pit. It will be scouted out. Abfinim spam-pinging it, but there's no way that they can get over, really. I mean, they've got Skylark in the neighborhood, but no one else is attending. I mean, he could try for something. And he is going to try for it, but he doesn't get it. Fly picks up the Aegis. Skylark loses his life.
Nice try. Valiant attempt.
I mean, you have to go for these plays, I guess, when you're kind of forced back at this stage of the game.
Guess how long ago Abfinim's last kill was?
A series, man. I mean, it's really slowed down for them. OG have just not allowed any cracks to show. And now they're moving in for that second set of racks. Buyback from Skylark. MNT will still be down for 35 seconds. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Madara has been caught out by S4, and he's down for 90 seconds. Jumping from Anna with a Hex onto the wall. Sanity's Eclipse is out, and they just tap it out. It's all too much for Abfinim here in game one. They've had some great wins recently over the last couple of days, but now meeting up against OG. This first match proving to be very, very easy for the side of OG. Abfinim, they're going to have to try something different in the rest of this series, Bane, because this game one, the plan just did not work out.
Yeah, OG, they didn't have a strong lane.